Hi there, this is your friend Virendra dear. I am at the top of a hill. As you can see all around, a beautiful nature, a beautiful surroundings. And as being a servant of mankind, always dedicated, committed to stimulate your intelligence, to let you realize that you are the master of your fate and you are the captain of your soul by virtue of the thought. You choose and encourage, and you will shape your destiny. You will make your life and you will create the conditions and circumstances and environment by virtue of the thought you choose and encourage. You will be what you will to be just because of the seed of the thought you are sowing in your heart, mind and soul. And as I, being a success philosopher, the student of great Napoleon Hill and Andrew Carnegie, this moment I am trying to convince you by some poems how you can be great and successful in life. Beloved friends, to be successful in life, you must know the success steps, principles, the various ways and means that you have to choose and you have to practice in life. If you want to be successful, you must have a definite goal and purpose in life. Then you must make a mastermind alliance with the best brains who can really help you with all the resources so that you can be really getting every support in the time of crisis when one after another you are meeting with stumbling blocks, defeats, failures, adversities, misfortune. And a time will come when you will break and you will be fragmented and disintegrated mentally, physically, spiritually. But these mastermind alliance people will encourage you, and your inner self, the other self, the spirit of your self-help will say, no, believe in yourself, have faith in God and have faith in infinite intelligence and faith in your own power of personality, the God-gifted great machine, incredible machine, the power of your brain, because whatever it will conceive and believe, it can reward you. And then if you keep on keeping on persisting with a definite plan of action, improving your plan and treading down all difficulties and danger, you are crowned to be successful in life. But there are so many greats who really sometimes doubt and hesitate, and they feel that opportunities are not unlimited. Opportunities seldom comes in life. Even the great poet like William Shakespeare wrote, there is a tide in the affairs of men, who's taken at the flood, leads on to fortune, omitted all the ways of their life. They are bound in sallows and miseries. On such a full sea are we all afloat. We must take the current when it serves, or we lose our venture. Beloved friends, who will be another William Shakespeare? The genius, the great, the person who connected his mind with God, and he ruled the heart of millions and millions of people. Still he reverberates in our mind. We always learn lessons from such great men. But even this great man is saying that opportunities seldom comes in your life. You must grab the opportunity. You should never allow to slip it from your hands. Otherwise, you will have to regret, repent throughout your life. But here in the science of success philosophy, the personal achievement programs which I am really teaching you, you should not bother for the opportunity gone, the chances gone, because you will create another great opportunity. Another great occasion will come in your life, and you will create your environment and circumstances when you can really come out with flying colors. Opportunities are unlimited. Because one great poet, Walter Mellon, said, they do me wrong who say I come no more. Once I knock and fail to find you in, for every day I stand outside your door and wake you to rise and fight and win. Beloved friends, opportunity will always come. Opportunity will always come. But you have to be sincere. you have to be putting all your effort with a very intelligent practical plan of action, and you should have use your extreme intelligence. Success is bound to be there. Success is yours. You will never fail unless you are a careless man, you are not committed and dedicated. At the very first sight of hindrances and obstacles, you give up and you quit. Then and only then you will fail. Otherwise, you are born to be great, you are born to be successful. I always recite poems with total understanding and deep-rooted perception of what the message the poet is conveying. Let me recite before you another great poem which will really convey what I have told you. Ulysses, a great inspiring poem composed by Lord Alfred Tennyson. He says, "Come, my friends, it never too late to seek a newer world. Push off, and sitting well in order as might, the sounding furrows for my purpose hold, to sail beyond the sunset or the bath of the western stars until I die. It may be that the gulf will wash us down. It may be that we can touch the happy isles and see the great Achilles, whom we know, though much is taken, much abides, and we are not that strength which in old days moved earth and heaven. That we are, which we are, an equal temper of heroic hearts, made weak by time and fate, but strong in will, to strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield." Beloved friends, permit me to recite this poem, the last stanza of this Ulysses poem, once more, because that always reverberates in my heart. Listen carefully. "Come, my friends, it's never too late to seek a newer world. Push off, and sitting well in order smite, the sounding furrows for my purpose hold, to sail beyond the sunset and the bath of the western stars until I die. It may be that the gulf will wash us down. It may be that we can touch the happy isles and see the great Achilles, whom we know, though much is taken, much abides, and we are not that strength which in old days moved earth and heaven. That which we are an equal temper of heroic hearts, made weak by time and fate, but strong in will, to strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield." Yes, beloved friends, what William Shakespeare said, that there is a tide in the affairs of man, which taken as the flood, really gives us all glamour, greatness, and success. But once the tide is gone, we are vanquished, we are defeated, and we have to regret throughout our life. That is not the case. The tides are just not one. The tide is your opportunity. The tides keep on coming and going, coming and going. Opportunities are coming and going, coming and going. But we must stick to it, and there will be a great opportunity. There will be a great which is allotted to us, which is our fate and destiny, and there we shall excel. So, beloved friends, you will be what you will to be. Let failure find its false content in the poor world environment, but its spirit scorns it and is free. It masters times, it conquers a space. It cows the boastful trickster chance. It beats the tyrant circumstance and crown, and fill with a servant's place. The human will that forces on sin, the offspring of a deathless soul, can hew a way to any goal, the walls of granite intervene. Be not impatient in delay, but wait. And one who understands, when his spirit rises and commands, the gods are ready to obey. You will be what you will to be. Dream lofty dreams, and as you dream, so shall you be one day. Your visions are the promises, what you shall attain one day. Your ideals are the prophecy, which you will realize one day, deliberately, definitely, successfully, because you desire, you dream, you persevere, you persist, and you are an equal temper of heroic heart. Tides of opportunity will come and go, but grab one opportunity, and one idea can change your world. Thank you very much for being my great friend, my inspiration, my motivation. I get inspired from you. Thank you very much.